Welcome to Yoga Flow. I'm Carla. I teach yoga at HealthQuest. I'm super bummed I can't be with you guys there this morning, but it's obviously for a good reason. So just give me a little post when someone comes on so I can see and make sure that this is working. I can see one of you. Cool. Three. Awesome. Right on. So happy Thursday. During this crazy time for all of us, I'm hoping that some of you parents are able to have a little quiet time to yourself. If not, welcome the kids around your space. It's totally fine. I'm sure you know how to make moves with littles running around your feet. I just want to check in and see if...
Cool.
All right, guys. So with that said, this is a yoga flow practice. What we're going to do here is lots of asanas, lots of simple yoga poses through movement with lots and lots of breath. So the focus is going to be working at your pace with your time. And just take options. There's plenty of them. Knees or toes, obviously, for chaturanga. And I can't stress it enough. Just take this next hour in my home with me that my husband so beautifully helped me set up this space. So with that said, we're going to start our practice lying down because why not? It's a beautiful way to start. So hopefully you have your mat. I have a double mat because I'm going to rotate from side to side. So just come with me and lie back down onto your mat. Starting off with what we call corpse pose. Obviously, we will evolve from here. But just taking a moment, closing your eyes, and I'm hoping that the music's not too loud. I have a gentle, soft music playing in the background. If it is, please let me know and I will take away the music. So just coming to lie flat on your back, on your mat. Closing your eyes and starting to soften your breath. Come with me and take your right hand and bring your right hand onto your belly and your left hand onto your chest. Eyes are closed, feet are falling open. Softness through the sacrum, softness through the eyes. We're just gonna take a few moments to come into a natural rhythmic breathing cycle. I'm doing Bikram yoga today, just in case anyone's noticed. If you want to pop next to your fireplace if you have one, it's not a bad idea. I feel like I'm getting a suntan. All right, so we're going to start our breathing cycle. We're going to inhale through the nose for the count of four. So come with me. Take a deep breath in. Hold. And then an exhale for the count of four. Three, two, one. Back out through the nose. We're going to do this again. So inhaling through the nose for the count of four. Inhale. Two. Three, four, hold at the top of your breath. And start that exhale just as deep. Exhale out through the nose for four, three, two, one. Again, inhaling through the nose, deep. Two, three, four, hold at the top of the breath. And then start the exhale deeper out the nose. Two, three, four. Taking one more breath like this, inhaling through the nose, two, three, hold at the top, and then let that breath go. Hold here for a moment, release hands towards the floor, opening up palms towards the sky, roll through the shoulders just a little, releasing the body, letting the body surrender towards your mat. Just feel how you feel with that breath, a nice comfortable breath to waken up the body. Bringing movement into the body now, we're gonna hug knees in towards chest. Give yourself a gentle hug, you deserve it. Rock around side to side, get a nice little massage on your back, and if you're laying on a stone floor like I am underneath these yoga mats, it should feel quite interesting. Getting a lot of acupuncture spots here. Awesome, good. Hug knees in. From here, we're gonna wake up the body, alternating leg press. So hug the right knee in towards the chest and start to press the left knee in towards the hand. Take that rock from side to side. Of course, we're breathing. Slow, soft, steady breath. You can keep the eyes closed here. I'm gonna do lots of word coaching, so you should be able to follow. Big inhale again through the nose. As you start to exhale, switch inside. So left knee hugs in towards chest, right knee presses into palm of hand. And we continue with that rocking from side to side if it feels good. Should be a nice little release on the back. Today's the first day I put makeup on for you guys, so you're welcome. Not sure if I remember how to do it. Again, inhaling right knee towards chest, left knee presses into palm of hand. Feel that starting to open up through the groin, open up through the hips. You can make this movement bigger and work with your flow. So inhale again, switching sides. Rock from side to side. Last time here, hug the knees in towards the chest, coming to a quick happy baby pose. Hands come to any place comfortable for you. So maybe that's the soles of the feet, inside or out. Maybe that's the calves to start. Taking a gentle rock from side to side. Again, close the eyes if it feels okay. Just come into your body, come into your space. I'm going to coach you, so you should be able to do these movements without having to watch me, although it's probably pretty entertaining. Breath flows. Breathe into the hips. Let the breath go. Hug those knees back in towards the chest again. Hug behind the thighs. Give yourself a little rock up towards your seat. I see lots of you on here. Thanks for joining, guys. This is awesome. I'm so stoked to be able to do this with you. Turning over, we're coming to tabletop. Reset yourself. I'm going to come side on so you can see my posture. Shoulders stacked right over the wrist, knees stacked under hips. Release through the crown of the head. So bring your gaze down, keeping that spine nice and long, stacked head in line with spine. Take a deep breath in. Start to curl tailbone, draw belly in towards spine, coming to cat-cow. So release the spine up towards the sky with a full breath in. Start to exhale, nod the tailbone back up towards the sky first. Then you let your belly fall, chest falls, head lifts. Good. So work with your breath. Inhaling again. Curl tailbone under, belly lifts towards spine. Arching the back nice and high. Release the neck. Full breath out. Release the tailbone again. Belly falls, chest falls, head lifts. Now you work again with your breath, again with your movement and pace and time. So each move we flow with even more breath. So every time you inhale, can you try to focus on having your exhale be a little bit longer than your inhale? We need this time, we need this for our bodies. We've been away from each other for so long. So allow yourself, since you're in the comfort of your home, just to breathe. Nobody's watching you. You're all watching me, and I'm breathing. Okay, we'll take one more like this. Inhale to lift. Exhale, let the belly fall. Let the chest lift. Coming back to our neutral spine, so reset your body. Lift the belly up towards the spine. Nice long neck, so reach longer through the crown of the head. From here, we're going to extend the left leg long, keeping that right knee bent directly under the hip. So nice rooted through the toes here. I hope you can see. I see come or post, but I can't see if you can see my foot. I think you can. So take an inhale. Start to rock back and forth, opening the back of that calf up. So this is going to be a nice opening for when we get into our down dogs here in a few seconds. So breathe. Every breath you take in, each exhale is longer. So think about lengthening the back of that calf muscle and softening the breath. All right, hold the posture back towards the heel. Again, lots of openness through that muscle, and then shift your body weight forward just so that you're stacked again, wrist over shoulder. I'm sorry, shoulder over wrist. Inhale. If you have this in you today, your right knee's grounded, your right hand lifts up, and we're going to thread the needle. So this is a little core activation. Big breath in. Open that right arm up towards the sky, just a little rotation through the spine. Lots of activation up out of that left supporting shoulder, breathing in again. Thread the needle, reach towards me. Come get you. Inhale, lengthen up towards the sky. And again, so you're moving with your breath and your range of motion. If this doesn't feel right for you today, keep with the just extension of the calf muscle. That feels good. Or maybe any time you take a child's pose. Lots of breath. Inhale to lift. Exhale, we'll do one more. Thread the needle, reach to me. Reach a little further. And then rise. Root that hand back towards the mat. Right hand grounds. Left knee bends back under hip. Now right leg extends long. Recenter yourself. Restack over your shoulder. Shoulders over wrist. And then start that gentle rock back and forth into the calf. Breathing. My children are playing outside right now, all three of them, so you're welcome. Although we are going to be doing a parent-child yoga class as well as a children's yoga class. So be excited for that. Again, breathing into that muscle. So think about lengthening and just softening. go. Full breath out, reach up towards the sky. Hand stacks back under shoulder. Knee comes in. One more cat-cow. And from here, ground through the hands. Tuck toes under. Keep knees bent as you press hips up, down, downward facing dog. Keep the knees soft here. Start to pedal your downward facing dog. So even weight through the fingers, even weight through the hands. Super square shoulders. Draw the belly in up towards the spine. And start to open up your downward facing dog. So full breaths here again. So your calves should feel pretty nice and open. You should feel pretty good still, but we have that opening that we've already done here. So once you've come to center, root through the heels, start to press back, opening up the shoulders, opening up the calves. Tuck the chin in towards the chest, coming forward to our plank pose, roll forward, knees lower. Come with me, we're lowering down for 5, 4, you there yet? 3, 2, 1, good. Shoulders roll back, elbows draw in towards sides, hands directly under, close to chest. Lift the chest, squeeze the shoulder blades, engage the glutes. Take a breath here, coming forward through with our chest. Baby cobra. Take a breath. Now if it's in it for you today, we're gonna roll the cobra. So taking an inhale, start to press in the palm of the hands. Full inhale, start to exhale, lower down, lengthen through the spine. Working again with your time, your breath. Each time we lift a little bit higher, each time we lower a little slower. Breathing in, lift. Breathing out, lower. Once more. This one, if you have it, bring you all the way forward to up dog. Thighs lift, chest towards sky. From here, tuck toes, knees bend, we press back to downward facing dog. Walk the dog for a few more breaths. Open the shoulders. And then from here, next breath, we walk our feet towards our hands, coming to a fold. Release your body forward and surrender to your fold. So allow yourself to surrender here. Let the shoulders be heavy. Now, if you want to bend your knees and let your belly rest on your thighs, that's okay. We're going to open up the hamstrings, so maybe take clasp on the opposite shoulder. Now, option here with pregnancy, or if you need a little bit more support, walk your feet out just a hair so that directly under your hips. Surrender yourself forward. Maybe take clasp of opposite elbow. Take a gentle rock from side to side. Nice opening through the upper back. Coming back through center, root through the hands. And with your next breath in, we're stacking our spine to come to stand. Arms reach up overhead. And hands to hips. Release the breath. Moving to sun salutations. Make sure this is flowing. That's cool. Awesome. I'm going to come to the front of my mat so you guys can follow the flow a little easier, I think, if I'm facing forward. So sun salutation A, soles of feet together, more support, hip distance. Root through the feet, lifting the toes. Let's take the close of the eyes if you have it in you today. Lift the toes, separate the toes, and let them root down onto your mat. Tailbone tucks under slightly to protect the lower back. Palms face forward. A little openness through the hands, a little openness through the fingertips, softness. And just taking a moment here to feel how your body feels standing. Feel that rooted feeling through your entire body. Full breath in, we're rising to extended mountain. Inhale through the nose. Arms reach up overhead. Now we're diving the chest forward, coming to swan pose. Lead with the heart, bend the knees, let the belly lift. Fingertips to ground, nice tempted fingers. Next, full breath in, hands to shin, flat back extension, lengthening through the crown of the head all the way down to the tailbone. Full breath in here, belly lifts again as we lower our body down, our chest lowers, come to fold. Rooted, nice and strong through those hands. Left leg, all the way back to lunge. Let that front knee stack over the ankle. Lift the chest, look up. Now you can look at my face. Take a full breath in, root through those hands, downward facing dog. Shoulders square, even weight through the hands, heels drop towards floor. Big breath in, tuck the chin, roll the body forward, coming forward to your plank. You choose, knees or toes, elbows draw in, elbows graze sides, elbows lower, halfway down. Squeezing glutes, lift the chest, baby cobra, up dog, or sphinx pose. Full breath in here, as you exhale, release the glutes, tuck the toes, downward facing dog. Press back into those heels, full breath in. Left leg, bend the knees, lunge forward again. Sink the hips low, lift the heart. Full breath, as we exhale, we fold, surrender. Feet together. Now hold here for two breaths. In through the nose. For four, three, two. Hold at the top of the breath. And then let that breath go. For four, three, two. Once more like that. Inhaling slowly. Hold the breath. And then let the breath go. Repeating the flow. So inhaling as we rise. Lift the chest. Stack your mat and reach tall. Longer through the fingertips. Exhaling, drawing that breath out as we fold, dive the heart forward. Inhaling, lengthening through the spine, press the shins away, flat back extension, half arch. Let that crown reach tall. Inhale, exhale as you fold, release. Hands root again, this time left leg lunge all the way back, long as you can. Knee over ankle, protect yourself, lift the chest, lower the hips. Next, full breath in, root through the hands, downward facing dog. Nice squareness through the shoulders, nice strong core, big breath in. Start to unravel your spine as you roll forward. Tuck the chin, draw the elbows in, knees or toes as you lower. Roll the shoulders back, lift the heart towards the sky. Squeeze the glutes, squeeze a little harder. Tuck your toes, now release your glutes, send your hips high. Now we're facing dog. Lunging forward, lower the hips, lift the heart. Surrender to your fold on your next breath out. Hold here for those two cleansing breaths again. We're going to pick up the flow for two more rounds of this sun salutation, so take advantage of these two breaths here in your fold. All right, we're going to stack our mountain. So inhale, let the belly lift you. Reach taller. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen, press the shins away. Exhale, fold. Lunging, lifting the heart. Exhaling, hips to dog. Unravel the spine, coming forward to plank. Nice strong through the core here as you lower. Lift the heart, squeeze the glutes, open the chest. Tuck your toes, downward facing dog. Lunging again, so bend the knees, spring that leg forward, help if you need to. Lift the heart, tuck the fingers, and fold. One more round of this sun salutation, big breath in, left. So let's lift our heart towards the sky. Reach, reach, reach. And let the breath go as you fold forward. Big breath in, press the shins away, half arch. Lengthen, and then surrender. Root through the hands, lunging again. Sink low this time, lift the chest. Hands root, downward facing dog. Hips high, unravel forward to your plank. You know your options, knees or toes, elbows locked in towards the body. Lots of strength here. Lifting the heart, glutes engage, protect the back. Now tuck your toes, now release the glutes. Let that opening happen. Hold here for a moment. Switching to sun salutation B. So, a little bit more strength in this one. I'm going to give you options. Nice rigid hands. Come with me. Walk your hands slowly back towards your feet. Inchworm. A fold here. Take a breath in your fold. And we're coming back to extended mountain. This time, hands through the midline. So hands come together. Just near your feet in prayer hands. Take a big breath in. We're going to roll our mountain. So inhale to lengthen. Reach. And then swan dive forward. Let the breath go. Hands meet through the midline. Prayer hands, roll them out in. Reach taller this time. Let the breath go. Dive heart forward. Once more, breathing in through the nose as you set the spine. Reach taller than before. Sorry for that. Hold here. Again, coming back to that strength. Friends, I invite you to inchworm out to your plank again. If you choose not to, we're going to just come to the plank any way that works for you today. Otherwise, carefully walking your hands out towards the center of the front of the mat. Inchworm, lower the hips. Feel the strength here. Elbows roll under. Chest lifts. Crown of head lifts to support the neck. Belly draws in to support the back. From here, release the hips. Downward facing dog. Right leg all the way forward, coming to crescent lunge. Let the leg foot ground, bend the back knee, arms rise, lift the chest. Now that back knee is lifted, we're in crescent lunge. Hearts open, shoulders roll back. Little strength building here, so front knee over ankle, push it forward if you have to, stack it. Take a breath in. Let the breath go. Hands through midline again. Turning body side on, arms to center. Turn this way, it might be a little easier. Elbow inside knee, hands to heart center. Shoulder rolls back, top shoulder. Nice, lots of leg activation here. So really press that sole of the foot away and just take a breath. Gaze can be down towards the floor or up towards the sky if that feels better. Next breath, open the arms. Really press that right elbow into the knee to open here. Arms sweeps towards floor, nice little windmill, coming back to a lunge. Hands root, downward facing dog. Next breath in, walking hands back towards feet. Inchworm. Repeat the flow, so surrender to your fold. Hands through midline, prayer hands, inhale, lengthen up towards sky. Swan dive, exhale forward. Inchworm again, hands root towards floor. We walk out towards our plank. Lots of strength here. Belly pulls in, beautiful plank. Plank nice and supported. Pressing hips back, downward facing dog. And this time, left leg takes the crescent lunge. Bend the knees, shoot that left leg forward, bend the right knee right away, and then lift the heart. Lots of strength. So check in with me here. Knee over ankle. Back knee about an inch from the floor. Chest open. Nice tucked tailbone here so you're super stacked. Shoulders over hips. Draw the shoulders back. Feel the strength and the power. And breathe. Are you breathing? I hope so. One more breath. Hands towards the heart as we extend into our warrior three. Pressing that front knee open, making sure it's still stacked here. Roll that top shoulder back. Feel that bottom elbow really push that thigh open. It feels good. Lots of strength through that back supporting leg. If it's for you, you stay here. Otherwise, take the open stretch. I'm sweating in front of this fire. It's good. Breathe. Top arm windmills down towards floor, coming back to your lunge. Hips, downward facing dog. Lower the heels, root through the hands. Take a breath, carefully walk the hands back towards the hips. I'm sorry, the feet. Inchworm. Hands through the midline. Rolling back up towards mountain. Arms reach up overhead. Exhale, hands towards hips. Now close your eyes for a moment with me. Let the hands fall to the hips. Lifting the toes again, rooting through the feet, palms face forward. We're gonna take two cleansing breaths here. Arms are gonna reach tall to extended mountain. And then we're gonna come down and breathe out through our mouth. Once more, inhaling through the nose, reach taller. And let the breath go. Cleanse the body. Much needed, stay here for a moment. Palms face forward, eyes closed. Allow yourself just to feel grounded, rooted. We're coming into a warrior sequence. It's a truly beautiful sequence, I believe. I'm going to face side on so that you can see the postures a little easier. So we're starting with chair pose. Front of the mat for you guys. I'm coming side on. So, soles of feet together. Start to sink back. Arms reach up overhead. Soften the shoulders down. Sink back into the hips. Chair pose, Utkatasana. Belly draws in. Tailbone tucks under, slightly protecting the back. Shoulders roll back. See if you can frame your face with your hands. Now, if you want a little bit more, a little challenge, option to lift the heels. But then you sink a little lower because Lord knows you're taking the challenge, yeah? Breathing. Now, if your littles are joining us today, please keep them safe. I'm hoping that my niece Lydia is here doing yoga with us. I think she might be. So keep breathing. From here, we're stepping back to crescent pose again. So, left leg long lunge back, heels lower. Sink into your lunge. Open the heart. Breathe. Exhale and open the chest towards the sky, letting the shoulder blades squeeze down behind you. Once more, inhale, lift. Extend the legs towards the sky. We're coming to a little bit of a dance. Exhale, lower. Slowly with breath, lots of activation through that back body. And legs. Who's talking about that? Breathing in again. Once more. Rise. Exhale, lower. Beautiful. Turning side on warrior two. Back foot's going to cut in just a little to protect the knee. Front knee again, over ankle. Now come with me, center of body. Inhaling the arms up, reaching the arms away. Coming into a little bit more strength because we all need it, right? Just breathe in here for a moment. Come into warrior two dance. Next full breath in, we rise, straightening the legs, reaching towards the sky. Exhale, lower, palms face up. Stack the knee, inhale to lift. Exhale, lower. Once more, inhale, rise. And then lower. Coming to extended warrior, reaching arms away, elbow to knee, elbow to hand to ankle, or maybe you extend away. A little bit more core activation, a little bit more strength in the legs. You choose your option today. But breathe. If you're here, press the elbow into knee to open the hip even more. Full breath in, windmilling arms, peaceful warrior, sun warrior. Arm reaches up overhead, now a nice beautiful C shape of the spine. Feel as though your ribs are fanning open, and then soften your top shoulder away from your ears. Just breathe. I could say a million things to distract you from the shape in your legs right now. How many dishes do you have in your sink? Full breath in, triangle pose, straightening the front leg, windmilling the arms, beautiful dance. Lengthen your body forward, send the hips towards the side of the room, and then see where you land. Maybe it's a block, maybe it's the shin, maybe it's outside on a float, but wherever you are, open up the shoulders and reach away. See if you can lift the ribs up off that thigh. Gaze towards floor, towards the sky. We're in no time. Oh, we're good on time. Breathing. And see if you can soften. Trying to stack those shoulders. And just take another breath in. Another breath out. We're going to turn the toes to face forward. A nice, beautiful lift of the belly as we reach towards the sky. Goddess pose, sink low here. Knees track over toes. Take a breath. Tailbone still tucks under. Roll the shoulders back. Feel that nice, beautiful openness through towards the chest towards the sky. Great. Another little bit of a dance here. Breathing in. Reaching up towards the sky. Straightening the legs. Exhale, sink low. Open the arm. Let the elbows fall. Two more. Breathing in. Lift. Exhale, lower. Last one, breathe. And let that breath fall. Good. Hands towards floor. Forward fold. So straighten out the feet towards me parallel. Let the body surrender forward for a moment. This is your forward fold. So where do you take it? Maybe you move the feet wider. Maybe you're stacked on blocks or your books that I offer in the description. whatever. Legos, I don't know, maybe you made a Lego block, I'm not sure. Whatever you fancy. If you have a piece of wood, you could use a piece of wood. So from here, come with me. Walk your hands towards your left foot and take that side fold. Most importantly here, if you need to bend that left leg so you can hug it towards your chest, keeping your hips nice and square towards the floor. But breathe softness somewhere. So take an inhale with me through the nose. And then soften as you exhale anywhere in your body. Walking hands towards center. Tented fingers reach long right out in front of you. So straightening the arms, coming to hammock pose. So same thing with the legs. Now see if you can shift your weight back towards your hips, almost like you're in a hammock. Let the chest fall. And again, we're softening. We're breathing breath into every space of our body. Carefully walking hands over to the right leg, giving that right leg the gentle hug it so deserves, carrying us through the days, bending it towards chest and able to keep hips square, and just breathing, surrendering yourself forward. Hands towards center of mat. Now you take your fold any way you like. Maybe you're resting head to floor. Maybe not. If not today, maybe tomorrow. From here, just because we're building strength, bringing hands to hips, you don't have to do this. You can do it any way that feels right. We're coming up with a flat back, so tuck the chin in towards the chest. Take a big breath as you lift the body back up to stand. One step together. Quick shake. Get to do the other side. Setting up for crescent pose again. So you're probably facing forward, so you can see that's perfectly fine. I'm going to start here. Soles and feet together. Chest lifts, arms towards sky. We sit back into our chair. Find your chair. Where is it? Now remember your option. You might keep the heels grounded. Otherwise, option to lift the heels, add a little bonus strength. But how high can you lift your heels? I know a lot of you probably wear high heels on the weekend. I do not. No judgment, I aspire one day. I don't know how fast I can run in high heels. Keep drawing the shoulder blades back. Chest is open. Breathe. Crescent lunge. Inhale, ground the left heel. Long stride back. Lift the heart. Checking in with that front knee. Is it stacking left ankle? Back knee drops about an inch from the floor. Coming back to that dance we started with. Inhale. Lift and lengthen, reach through the fingertips. Exhale, lower the arms towards the floor. Squeeze the shoulder blades, lift the heart. Inhale to lift. Exhale, lower. Now let's see on this third round if we can lower a little bit more. Inhale, lifting. Exhale, sink into those legs. Lift the heart even more. Beautiful wiggle of the arms to open us to warrior two. How we doing? Good. Stacking knee because that's the most important thing. Press that knee out, engage that outside glute. Press the sole of the floor away. Square your hips right to the midline. Soften the shoulders. Breathe. Warrior two dance, palms face up. Inhale, straightening the legs, reaching tall here. Exhale, sink low, soften the shoulders, drop them down your back. Maybe my other nephews and niece are doing this with us also. I hope they are. Inhale, lift. I hope they are. Exhale, lower. Last one, breathing. Inhale to reach towards the sky. Exhale, sinking low. Extending our warrior. You know your options. Elbow to knee, ankle, or float. Reach first. Extend. Now you might sit here and that's okay. If you are, see if you can soften a little bit more. Take the work out of where it doesn't need to be. Maybe you're reaching, coming a little bit lower into the hips, or maybe you're finding a little strength and opening. Breathe. Top shoulder keeps rolling back. Keep pulling that belly in, support yourself. We need all the support we can get right now, yeah? Just keep breathing. Coming back to peaceful warrior, sun warrior, floating arms up through the center, coming to a windmill. Beautiful inhale. Exhale, lengthen. Reach down that back leg. C-shape your body. So keep pushing forward and feel that openness through the ribs. Top shoulder drops down. Just breathe here. Coming back to that windmill through triangle pose. Inhaling. Arms float through the center. Straightening that front leg. Reach, reach, reach. Hip sends away towards that back wall. You choose your option. Block, shin, or float. Roll that top shoulder back. Belly pulls in. Stack the shoulders towards the sky. And breathe. Are you breathing? Coming back to our beautiful goddess pose. Windmill feet, or pivot toes towards the center of the room. Little face wing outwards, opening the chest towards the sky. Sink into the hips. We're still strengthening our legs here. Shoulders roll back, soften. And a beautiful goddess stance. Inhale to lift, lengthen the legs. Exhale, lower, draw the shoulder blades back and down. Feel that openness through the front of the body. Inhale again to rise. Exhale, lower. Once more, breathing in. And let the breath go. Sink deep into your pose. Folding once more, hands to floor. Pivot feet forward, parallel towards me. Take that beautiful forward fold. It should feel nice to release your back. Just surrender here. Coming through options for twisting in this pose. So if you have a block and you'd like to use it, I fully support it, or any other apparatus in your home, which I'm sure you could find something. I'm looking at my son's spiked bike helmet thinking, won't do that. Right hand to center of mat, block, or whatever you find. We're stacking our shoulders here. So first and foremost, push up out of that right hand. Feel how it lifts you up out of your shoulder. Hand towards back. So now you're already opening. This might be where you stay. Some of us don't have open shoulders, and that's okay. If you're with me, take a breath in. Start to turn your shoulders so that they're facing the side of the room. Hips are nice and square, still towards the floor. Big breath in. If you have it, top arm floats towards sky. Keep that gaze down towards the floor. Protect the neck, but keep pushing out of that right hand. See if you can get more revolve through your spine. And breathe, of course. Opposite side. Let's root down through that left hand first. Come with me. Push up out of that left hand. Take that pressure out of that left shoulder. Hand to hips. Are you square? I think so. Press the hips back. Nice activation through the core. You might stay here. Next breath, if you've got it in, you turn your shoulders, and then that float happens. And remember, if not today, maybe tomorrow. But just breathe lots of space into the body. Twisting is medicine for our spine. So every opportunity you can, see if you can find a twist. Hand reaches towards floor. From here, we get to come down to our mat. Release the legs. How are we doing? Come with me. Just get your legs a little shake from side to side. That was a heavy, heavy load. I hope you enjoyed that sequence. So we are coming down to some beautiful hip openers here. Again, every pose has an option, and I'd love for you to take one that you feel challenged yet successful with. So with that said, right leg is going to hug in towards thigh. Left leg's gonna bend. You might stay here with foot outside shin, or you might stay with leg, bottom leg extended, top leg crossed over. If you've got it in you, we'll take a seated twist here. So we're hooking that top leg over, rooting down through both feet and sit bones. So if you can't find your sit bones on the floor, let's talk about extending that bottom leg, or maybe just taking it outside the shin. Find something comfortable for yourself here. So ground through the sit bones, ground through the feet. I'm going to invite you again to close your eyes, because why do they need to be open? I'm goofy old maze. Nothing's going to change. Take a deep, big breath in. Hug that left knee in towards the chest, or whatever leg you're working with, guys. The cueing is going to be different for all of us. We're all going to be doing different things, and I welcome that. Left hand's gonna root down behind the hips. Now start to hug that knee in towards the chest. You should feel a beautiful opening through that glute muscle. And revolve, looking over that back shoulder with closed eyes. You don't need to actually look with your eyes. You can look with your intention. So sitting up nice and tall, breathing that knee in towards the chest, and just close the eyes and breathe softness into the body. Let this twist happen. I promise you, you don't have to open your eyes to see if I've changed positions. I will tell you. And you might stay here, and I welcome you to do so. Otherwise, if you'd like a little bit more, taking hold of the outside edge of that left foot, reaching that leg long, keeping a nice soft micro bend, left arm extends long behind us. Now we have a lever. We're going to use that left right hand to pull that left leg across the midline, and then reaching more with that left arm, finding length from toes to fingers. Now the more you bring your gaze over that left shoulder, the more twist you might find. Soften the breath. Remember, twisting, medicine for the spine, and beautiful work for our digestive tract. So keep softening somewhere. Releasing the foot forward. If this needs to be released, coming to easy pose, that's okay. Actually, let's come to easy pose. So you can come seated with feet crossed, or maybe you stack the foot up over, coming to modified half lotus. Again, sitting nice and tall on your sit bones, taking a full breath and lengthening through the spine. On your exhale, walking the fingertips forward, coming to a fold. Feel that beautiful opening in that left hip and softening through the shoulders. Now you might stay with tented fingers. You might not take the fold. This might not feel good for you. Again, remember, you're on easy pose or modified half lotus. My husband's gonna come turn the fire down. Karma 10. Just breathe. I am sweating, so it's much appreciated.
Good job, guys.
From your walking fingertips back up, stacking the spine, we're coming to a side bend. So if you can, turn the body over the left knee that's on top, walking the fingertips out. And now you're going to feel that beautiful opening up the side of the right side of your body. So surrender your body forward, breathe. Again, if it feels right, eyes are closed. It's your body, it's your breath. Tented fingers, walk ourselves back up to a seated position. We're gonna switch sides, so carefully unhook the legs, give them a quick shake, release that lactic acid. Other side. We come back to our twist. So left foot comes into the thigh. You choose your option, shin, cross, or bottom leg extended. Root down through the hips. Feet grounded. Take that hug in towards the chest. Give yourself that gentle hug you deserve. You're working for it. Big breath in, right hand to hips. Start to revolve, looking over back shoulder with your closed eyes. So see if you can lengthen up through the crown of the head and see if you can find more twist. Breathing. And again, softening. Maybe you're finding tension in your fingertips. Let that go. Tension through the toes. And of course, all of us, tension through the shoulders. Release your twist, come forward towards knee. Hand, left hand to outside edge of right foot. Extend that leg. Sit tall on those sit bones. Nice soft bend in the knee. Big breath in. Lengthen through that right arm. Feel that lever across the body. Take that twist. Reach away. Fingertips to toes. Nice length through the crown of the head. Breathing. Carefully release your pose, guys. Once more, we're coming back to easy pose, your choice. Feet crossed, opposite leg on top this time. So if you're following with my legs, it's right leg on top. Nice activation through the foot. Protect the ankle, protect the knee. Sitting nice and tall here. Big breath in. Exhale, tented fingers. Walk our body as far forward as you can. Any amount's fine. But keep that foot nice and flexed so you can feel protected through the knee. And where are you letting go of? Shoulders, fingertips. Breath flows into that right hip. Maybe you take a soft rock from side to side. Taking our next breath in, we walk our bodies back up to stacked position. Ground here, next big breath out, walking over our right leg. So that side bend here. Now you feel that right away up that left side of your body. Now if you're anything like the rest of us, we've not been doing what we're normally used to doing since we haven't been at our home, HealthQuest. I know I have probably some people joining in today that aren't HealthQuest members, but you should consider it because it's a wonderful gym. But I'm grateful that we get to do these practices with you from home or from the gym Stephanie's doing there, filming at the gym. Just her though. Softening the breath. And then we walk our body back towards the center of the mat and tented fingers lift our spine up to seated. Extend legs long. Give them a quick shake here. And guys, I invite you to grab something warm. Maybe you're taking this time to get a sweater, some socks. We're gonna come down onto our backs here for the rest of the practice. So I invite you, please get something that you're gonna be comfortable for the rest of this time with us together. So with that said, roll onto your back, hugging behind the calves. We did it. Taking a deep breath in, closing the eyes again, because why not? Rooting through the soles of the feet, knees stack up towards the sky. Let the shoulders roll back. And just feel that openness through the back of the body. From here, we're coming to figure four. So right leg's going to cross over left knee. Flex with the foot. Let that hip push open. You might use your hand to gently open that hip. We are nice and open here, so you might have a little bit more mobility than we did at the beginning of our practice. Take the breath in towards that hip. Next breath lifts our legs up. Our left leg up, or you might stay grounded. That might be enough for you. If you have it in you, use your right elbow to open that hip, and if you want a little bit more, lift that left leg up towards the sky. Just that nice, beautiful opening. We're finishing our practice here soon, so let's just take every last minute we can together before we have to get back to the reality of homeschooling, working from home, all the things. Bend that left foot back down towards the glute. Let that foot come back down towards the floor. Now we're coming to figure four with supine twist. So let the arms fall open towards the sides of the room. From here, you might unravel that foot or keep it here. We're gonna let the legs fall down towards the left side of the room. Feels so good. So that nice cross leg just gives us a little bit more. You might have unhooked it, and that's fine. This is your supine twist. I invite you now to close your eyes. Arms are nice and extended, both shoulders rooted down towards the floor. So, with that said, if you need to unhook the leg or extend the top leg, you need a little bit more, take it. But what are we doing? We're breathing. Softness somewhere. What about softening the shoulders, softening that right hip, softening the fingertips, and softening the gaze. Now I find the easiest way to get out of a supine twist, turn your body towards the left side of the room, unhook, and then let your knees roll back towards center. Quick rock from side to side to release the lower back. A little back massage on my rock floor. Root down through the feet again. This time left foot crosses over right knee. Flex foot to support. You might stay here, pushing that hip open, and that's fine. And every day we build a little bit more. Next breath, if it's for you today, lifts the legs up towards the sky. Hugging that left, right thigh in towards the chest. You might stay here, or maybe you lengthen the leg up towards the sky. Your body, your practice, you might be rocking, you might be stable, your eyes might be open, your eyes might be closed, but everything's flowing with breath. the side. Let that right leg cross over. And then take your supine twist towards the right side of your wall. Maybe you welcome a little adjustment. And again, you might unhook and just take legs bent. You might lengthen that top leg, or you might keep that leg crossed under. Wherever you are, see if you can really ground your left shoulders. Maybe the gaze falls back over the left arm. Breathe. Follow me, turning body towards the right side of the room. Have knees to chest and take that rock back through center. Rocking side to side, feel that beautiful openness of the hips. Now maybe you come a little wider with the legs. We started here, we end here. Back to our happy baby pose. Feet to soles of feet to hands, hands to shins, hands inside or outside feet, you choose. Eyes closed, please. That flow. Rock side to side if it feels right today. You might play with lengthening one leg long and then lengthening the other leg. Just finishing our practice here with your pose. Maybe you're lengthening both legs to extension. Full breath in and then an exhale to draw back towards happy baby. Let's do two more if you're following me here. Inhale, lengthening. Full breath out. Let those knees fall closer towards the ribs. Softening shoulders, inhaling again, softening the face. Exhale, release. Now I invite you to join me for bound angle pose, lying down or star pose. So soles of feet together, feet towards floor, knees fall open. Now rearrange your body so that your whole body is rooted to the mat. Wiggle the hips a little, untuck the tail. Reset your shoulder blades down. Now you might find it to be comfortable to keep hands to belly, hands to floor. But if you want, extend arms up overhead, hugging the elbows. One, two, one elbow with one hand. Close the eyes. So we're going to bring awareness back into our breathing, our rhythmical breath that we started with. So let's talk about taking a deep inhale through the nose for the count of four. 3, 2, 1, hold at the top of the breath, and then start to let that breath flow back out through the nose for the count of 4. 3, 2, 1, we're going to do two more rounds like this. Inhale, 2, 3, hold your breath, and then let that breath go. 2, 3, last round here, inhale again, 2, 3, hold, and then let that breath flow. Now I invite you to stay here if this place feels right for your body today. Otherwise, if you'd like to take a few moments of Savasana with me, I invite you to find a comfortable place for your body today. So with that said, keep your eyes closed because there's nowhere in the world right now that you need to be. And if there is, I thank you for joining us. Otherwise, maybe elbows on the clasp. Palms are gonna face up outside edges of the mat. We're gonna start, either stay here or we're gonna extend right leg down and then left leg down. Let the legs fall to the outside edges of your mat. Hips nice and open, so feel that beautiful openness through the knees, that softness through the ankles. Let the feet be heavy. If it feels right, palms are facing up, just letting that soft breeze flow over your fingertips. Just as nice softness through the upper body, softness through the hips, and softness through the knees. Now if you're more comfortable seated, that's perfectly fine. I just invite you to let your body rest here heavy for a few minutes. Turning the gaze inwards towards the center of your forehead. And trying to make maintain that beautiful rhythmic breathing flowing through the practice, flowing through the body. And just bring gentle awareness to each part of your body. Softening through the shoulders, through the glutes, through the hamstrings, quads, calf muscles, and toes. You. So keep your body still. Just allow the breath to flow. And allow your body to surrender. You've worked for this. Just feel heavy. Start bringing awareness back into your breathing first, slowly. Inhaling through the nose, let the belly rise. And then a full breath out, let that belly fall. Gentle awareness being brought back into the fingertips and toes. Take it slow with your body. Maybe let the ankles roll side to side, releasing the wrists. In your time, maybe you're taking a gentle hug for the knees in towards the chest, one leg at a time here. Knees hug in, and we rock side to side. Like that gentle back massage. Eyes can stay closed here. Let's let that breath flow. If you're with me here, taking the rock to the right-hand side of your mat, allowing yourself just to rest here for one more breath cycle, in through the nose. Letting the breath fall. In your time, pushing your way up to a seated position, keeping the eyes closed, finding your way to a nice easy pose, cross leg. Keeping the eyes closed, we're going to end our practice with three cleansing breaths here. Position. Arms are going to reach tall up overhead, inhaling through the nose, arms reach tall, arms fall, exhale through the mouth, two more, breathing in to reach towards the sky, in through the nose, out through the mouth, last one, inhale, and let the breath fall, hands towards heart center. In this time of uncertainty, be grateful for one another. We are such a strong community. This too shall pass. We will fight through this together, and we will continue to do these classes. Guys, I appreciate you more than you know. I'm so grateful to have you in my home today. My littles, of course, had to make a little cameo. Be true to one another. Be true to yourselves. Be helpful. Be kind. And, of course, namaste.